Wow, that's kind of heavy, as you'd expect.
Look how flat that is.
Despite being over 60 years old, this flathead engine is still very durable. I'm keen to investigate the internal workings of the engine because my plan is to significantly boost performance.
To make this engine perform better, you need to make it breathe better. So what you need to do is find a way of getting more fuel and air into the engine and then get a better compression so you get a much more powerful bang, and then find a way of getting the exhaust out of the manifold as quickly as possible. So clearly, I need to do a bit of research.
The Flatty is still enormously popular on the hot rod scene, so off-the-shelf parts to help boost power are available.
Now the first place to start really, I guess, is the heads. We want to try and get the gas to flow through them much more easily. Now, I found a pair here of modified heads, and they are, in fact, they're custom made by the looks of it, custom designed. And they're about $600 for the pair, seems okay.
I find an inlet manifold, new carb kit and headers. These high performance parts will boost engine output by at least 30 horsepower, but the price tag is over $1,600, around £1,000.
While we were waiting for all these lovely shiny parts to turn up, we got busy with the block. So we've cleaned it and we've painted it, but of course, we're actually all about go as well as show, which is why we've got these wonderful alloy heads. And you can see they're very different from the original ones. There's two main differences. The first is there's a lot more kind of depth around the valves, which means you're going to get a lot more gas flow, but also you can see the chambers up here are different shapes. And in fact, it means you've got much more compression as well. So it is going to run a lot better with these on.
It's vital that the new heads are torqued down accurately, as this means better reliability and less chance of head gasket failure. I've chosen to fit threaded studs, not bolts, as they're specifically designed to create near-perfect alignment between the gaskets and the head. The nuts will eventually be tightened to a precise 55 foot-pounds of torque.
Now, a useful top tip when it comes to this engine is obviously once we've got it in the car, run it up to temperature, got it nice and hot. Something to bear in mind is the aluminium is going to expand and shrink at a different rate to the cast iron. And because of that, you want to re-torque the heads once it's cold again, just to be absolutely sure everything's perfectly tight.